I didn't think I was, it was so incremental. Like, I didn't think I could get this prize to start with at all. Like, that was the most unexpected thing ever. When I was, I got a letter saying I was a finalist, I had never been to Washington, D.C., and the interview was in D.C., and I thought, I get a trip to D.C. out of that. Like, I didn't see past that. And I thought, oh, this is great. For me, for like a couple of weeks, the Gabriel Prize meant I get to go to Washington, D.C. Like, a lot of the drawings I made, I ended up printing and sending back to the towns and telling them how much their patrimony had value, and they were letting it go to waste and get decayed. And actually, some people emailed me saying, can we use your letter to try to get some money to fundraise for the preservation of the building? So there were a couple of the Lavoirs that, simply by having a so-called American architect come and spend some time studying and measuring and painting them, to them, they understood its value. Via the Western European Architecture Foundation. I mean, in a way, that's the best that the foundation can hope for, is that it makes an impact on the actual architecture on the ground. I think the summer of the Gabriel Prize was really like the beginning of the next chapter in my life. Everything after that lined up according to that summer.